Notice requirements of the open public meeting law have been satisfied concerning this meeting. The Home News Tribune and the Star Ledger published a notice on December 16, 2016. It was also posted on the municipal bulletin board, and that should be so noted in the minutes of the meeting. Councilman Anderson.
Here.
Councilman Ficarra.
Here.
Councilwoman Drum.
Here.
Councilwoman De Jesus.
Here.
Councilman Spiller.
Here.
Councilman Small.
Here.
Councilman Patel.
Here.
Vice President Meehan.
Here.
And President Delina. Can I get a motion to approve the minutes from the February 21st, 2017 meeting?
Motion.
Any questions or comments? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Beginning with second reading ordinances tonight, starting with letter A, which is an amendment to the Jacobs Landing Rehabilitation Plan. Letter A, can I get a motion that this ordinance be taken up on second and third reading and the public hearing be open?
Motion.
Any questions or comments? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. The public hearing is now open on letter A. Letter A only. Seeing no comment from the public, can I get a motion that the public hearing be closed, the ordinance be adopted, and submitted to the mayor for approval as required by law?
Motion.
Second. Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Letter B is an amendment to the ordinance for the New Brunswick Avenue Rehabilitation Plan. Can I get a motion that this ordinance be taken up on second and third reading and the public hearing be open?
Motion.
Second. Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. The public hearing is now open on letter B. Letter B only.
Good evening, Council Vice President Meehan. Yeah. I'd like to thank Mr. Mitch. He made it really clear of what exactly the amendment was to the.
Can you state your name and where you're from for the
record? George Ibaka, hold on. Okay. I'd like to thank Mr. Mitch. He made it real clear. I asked what they were amending, and evidently it was one fellow that wanted to be left out of the rehabilitation plan. Too bad Councilman Delina is not here tonight, but you know, I'd like to stand before you tonight and just say, hey, listen, the area does need a lot of rehabilitation. You got to spend some of that pilot money down there in the southern area of the township, Oakland, Ford's, Casby, and make sure that the storefronts and everything are, brought up to stuff. Parking, it's a problem, okay? And I'd like to, just take this chance over here to tell you that, it's been 8-10 years since Highland Rule did the initial survey of it back in, I think it was 2007, 2008. And the economy and everything tanked. But now you got the money, you have all these big businesses coming into the township. Put some of the pilot money down there in Oakland, Ford's, and Casey. Thank you.
Any other comments from the public on letter B? Letter B only. I see no other comment. Can I get a motion that the public hearing be closed, the ordinance be adopted, and submitted to the mayor for approval as required by law?
Motion.
Second. Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Letter C is an amendment to the ordinance chapter 7. This is to designate handicapped parking spaces as noted. Can I get a motion that letter C be taken up on second and third reading and the public hearing be open?
Motion.
Questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. The public hearing is now open on letter C, letter C only. Seeing no comment from the public, can I get a motion that the public hearing be closed, the ordinance be adopted and submitted to the mayor for approval as required by law?
Motion.
Second. Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Letter D, an amendment to Ordinance 16-52 of the revised ordinance of the Township of Woodbridge, and this is to include an additional definition of ordinary maintenance. Can I get a motion that this ordinance be taken up on second and third reading and the public hearing be open?
Motion.
Second. Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. The public hearing is now open on letter D only. Seeing no comment from the public, can I get a motion that the public hearing be closed, the ordinance be adopted and submitted to the mayor for approval as required by law?
Motion.
Second.
Questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Letter D is an ordinance establishing salary ranges for the employees of the Township of Woodbridge. Can I get a motion that this ordinance be taken up on second and third reading and the public hearing be open?
Motion.
Second.
Can comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. The public hearing is now open on letter E, letter E only. Seeing no comment from the public, can I get a motion that the ordinance, that the public hearing be closed, the ordinance be adopted and submitted to the mayor for approval as required by law?
Motion.
Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Under first reading ordinances, just one letter tonight, letter F, and it's an ordinance adopting the amended Havenhill Arts Village redevelopment plan. Can I get a motion that this ordinance be taken up on first reading, published in the Home News Tribune on March the 10th, 2017, with notice of public hearing to be held on March 21st, 2017 at 7 p.m.?
Motion.
Second.
Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Before you are resolutions numbered 1 through 37. Can I get a motion that 1 through 37 be approved by consent?
Motion.
Second.
Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Ayes
have it. Madam President?
We will now go into our public portion of the meeting. If anybody would like to speak, please go back to the microphone. Please state your name and where you're from, and you have a limit of 5 minutes to speak.
Good evening, Council Vice President Meehan. Gerard Trevon, Hope on. Yeah, too bad Council Galena is not here tonight. I sent him some stuff about back in Forge in 1947, they were supposed to build a civic center. So now with the people of you building a senior center over there at the old first aid squad, maybe you could integrate that architecture into it. This is proposed civic center and a first aid building from, oh my God, October 1947. So like I said before, spend some money down there in Forge, Holtline, Casby, really needs it. Are those motorcycles we're buying for the motor patrol for Woodbridge Township, will they be American motorcycles, and will they go out on big yet? Anybody know?
It will be American made. No, we haven't gotten that far yet as far as the...
Okay, yeah, got their bid specs on it. And I gotta bring it up again, but hey, about the cover-up, about the cops and stuff like that. It's going to be 2 years in June. The camera's a dead issue until next year. The money is there for the funding. You people got to go get that money, and you got to put the body-worn cops on the body cameras on the cops, okay? It has to be done. Perth Amboy's doing it. Edison's doing it. Carteret's doing it, okay? And it has to be done.
President, if I could, before it goes any further.
Don't take me aside.
Stop the clock. The outrageous comments that we hear repeatedly about a cover-up
are just not true.
They're inappropriate. They're inappropriate. This issue's been dealt with on numerous times. Mr. Trabaca insists on coming here on a periodic basis and making these inappropriate, untruthful, unquestionably arrest statements.
You got arrested? You need the body cams, right? It's that simple. You need the body for...
All right, now, Jerry, I think what happened here was the chair yielded the floor to me.
Floor.
I think that's what happened.
You done?
No, I'm not done.
You stopped the clock?
I think the clock was stopped.
Okay.
Am I correct? Well, then would you stop interrupting me? You're not on the clock any longer, but this is classic of your behavior here. Inappropriate, untruthful, knowingly.
Untruthful.
Excuse me. Dishonest. Council Vice President, thank you.
Do you have anything else, Mr.
Trevon? Yeah, I mean, it's not going to be the exception, it's going to be the norm, okay? You're going to need these body cams in order to validate what the citizen says. It protects the officer, or it protects the citizen, and it protects the community, okay? Let's leave it at that, okay? Right now, you're gonna have the a referendum for the school, right? It's coming up this coming 14th, I believe, on there. It says over here, funding sources from the Board of Education, anticipated tax increase, zero, okay? Over here, It says, this is the give out to, for the people or whatever. It says total cost to taxpayers, zero. Okay? All right? What's the difference between total cost and anticipated cost? Anticipated tax increase? Anybody?
I'm not sure what the question is.
I'm confused too.
I don't think, there is no impact as a result of the referendum. So I'm not sure exactly where Mr. Jabach is going there.
Well, I mean, see, incidentals and stuff like that, plowing snow, heating the buildings and stuff like that, supporting infrastructure that didn't exist before. Okay? The buildings might be funded by the pilot, right?
The school existed before.
Pardon?
The school existed before.
School number 29 existed before. All right, it didn't exist before. Anyway, I got this thing here in the corner, Pravda, I mean, the corner over here on a page thing, page 5. It's giving out a total project cost $75 million. And over here is the grand total of $57 million. And can you give me a heads up on that? I'll give you the paperwork. And if you can't have it for me now, have it for me at the next meeting, okay?
Council Vice President, there's a total cost of the referendum. There's also state money that will receive to offset the cost.
So someone else will get first the state money.
Sir, your time's up.
Council Vice President.
Now? Are you going to wait till later on? The comments for the peanut gallery? Over there?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Council Vice President, Mr.
Attack the people after they sit there.
He's again, he got an opportunity to talk now. He's going to try to interrupt me as he did the business administration.
I'm not interrupting him, Council President. What? The general.
This is an interrupting.
To be rated, okay? The general public is rated. Okay. To be continued.
He continually comments about body cams, talks about funding be available. There's very limited funding. They're a lot more expensive. I spoke on body cameras some time back, all the reasons why we aren't going to them at this point. I'm not going to bore you with all those facts again. Mr. Trabalka brought it up when the CALEA accreditation team was here. We spoke to the accreditation team. They wanted to know our reasons. They agreed with our reasons, both on a professional level and a personal level. Again, Mr. Trabalka talks about body cams and they're going to be the cure-all. They're not. But at some point, we may look at it. But at this point, we are not. And that's just the way it is.
Any other comments from the public?
My name is Carolyn Ambrose, and I was violated 7 times.
Yes, ma'am. Where you're from, please, what town you're from?
I'm from KSB, New Jersey.
Thank you.
I was violated 7 times. January 14th, violated twice that day. Morning and afternoon, I learned how to swim. Now I know how to swim. When I got out of the pool and I went into the shower room, the lady sat there with her son. Take me about right here, Indian woman. Right here, and I'm in the nude. Get ready to take a shower here. That's what he was doing to me. In the afternoon, the same thing, but a different woman with her son, Indian woman, same thing. Come out the pool, go in the shower, in the nude, and here they come. Like they wanted to jump on me. That was January 14th. January 18th, the same thing, but it was a set of twins. Looked like girls, they were boys. Hair curl, sit there, and I'm here, and they right here, and her mama got her head down and they look at me. Stupid me, I'm saying, well, I may be different from your mother here, and just going up, doing all of that, not knowing they were boys, until January 21st. Indian woman coming in, she was in there with her mother, daughter, whoever. All I know, I felt something looking at me, and I looked down, 2 little midgets. Looked like boys, no, looked like girls, but they were boys. Come on. I went down to rub my leg because I got that chickenpox shot, the shingles or whatever. And my leg was hurting, so I went down and I rubbed my leg and I went up, they was in my face. What is going on? Well, I've been bringing my boys here for a whole year. I say, what? A whole year she been bringing her sons here to look at the women? How dare she? I turned to a different person. I don't want to say what I said. But she told me she been bringing them there for a whole year, and if I didn't like it, take it outside. I said, sons, I'm gonna do just that. If you wouldn't open up your big mouth, nobody would know. I said, I'm gonna take care of this. When I went, I was so upset, because I felt like I was raped. How dare she tell me she been doing that for a whole year? That's some kind of nerve. Dressing your boys up like girls for coming to shower room to look at us. And I know other women knew it, because that's why those women wear those bathing suits inside and don't follow the state rules. You're supposed to take a full body wash before you go in, and a full body wash when you come out. I told them I'm gonna find out. But the thing is, 7 incidents happened to me, not Sally, Sue, Geraldine, or nobody. To me. I'm supposed to tell this story. It should have been told a long time ago. And I feel I deserve some respect. I earned it and I deserve it. Like Aretha says, R-E-P-C-T. Find out what it means to me. R-E-P-C-T. Take care of TCP. I am very upset because nobody.
You have to get back by the microphone.
Nobody, when it first happened, John Kay, part of Beto's team. I told him what had happened to me. I went to the door, I said, John, you need to come take care of this. What? I say, the lady's in there with her son, dressed up like a girl, looking at me in the nude. Well, that shouldn't be. I say, what? You're not gonna come and see? That man sit there, and it was packed out there. That's how loud he was with me. He got loud with me, and I got loud back. Am I angry? Yes. I don't like it. Beto, Paul, his assistant, none of them. All they had to do to me was hug me and say it's gonna be all right. None of them did it. I'm very upset. I don't like it. It's wrong. And I'm done.
Okay, thank
you. I said my piece. I feel better now.
That's good.
Are there any other comments from the public?
Anybody else? Oh, man, it's a tough act to follow. Robert Mizzi, help. 434 Alpine Street, Perth Amboy. It's all about you, Judge George Boyd. It's all about you, what you're doing to me. That's why you can watch Channel 34. I don't have no cable. Thank God I don't have to watch what I'm doing, because I'll be so embarrassed. Okay, you can watch 34 and 35, Judge George Boyd, and you know, see me make a fool out of myself. Maybe you feel a little, I don't know what you feel. You know, you should have dismissed the case. There was no case at all. But the lady across the street was your client, and I used to look after her. One time I looked after her, I called the police, I didn't find her. Now she got mad at me, and there was all kinds of problems. I guess she tried to talk to the Judge York Boyd, you know. Then they wanted my license, my insurance. See, looking out for someone. Nobody looks out. Well, yeah, one guy looks out for me. Yeah, the watchtower. They come over to my house in the wintertime, see how am I doing. You know, that's one thing about them. They get a big rap, bad rap, but they're all right. My church, the Catholic Church, all they do is run collections. There'll be 3 collections today, the 3rd one for the heat, or so on, and you know. And Mitch, the municipal clerk, he's pretty nice. He comes in, he says hello to everybody. Not like you, Beto. Beto, I'm a big supporter of your concerts, and you say hello to the other guy, you ignore me, I'm always asking about what's going on. I tell you, come over, you probably let me, I figure you let me know when's the first show. You don't care, that's all right, I'm an out-of-towner.
I don't think the schedule's been finalized yet, but I'm sure when it is, they'll get it to you.
Yeah, I finally called the mayor's office, and the girl took my name, and she's going to send me, as soon as she gets the information, she's going to send a listing. That's what I got to look forward to, go see concerts and maybe hug with that young lady. So, that's nice, the concerts. That keeps me going. They got Monday, Tuesday.
all over the area. Okay, I'm going to talk about, I'm a big supporter of the police. You know what that guy was saying, he's right. I'm beginning to believe what I'm going through the past 4 years. I'm beginning to believe that people have a right to what they're doing. I don't know if I'm right or wrong. What do you think? You think I'm right or I'm thinking about it? Because what I'm going through over here, I got... Can I give this to someone to read the date I got to go to? I can't read it. I can't see it. Is it right, Vice President Maiden?
You can give it to Mr. Mitch.
Pardon me?
You can give it to Mr. Mitch.
Mr. who?
Mr. Mitch, right here.
Okay, after soon I'm done. Okay, yes. I got a miserable life, what I'm going through. I don't know, like he says about the police. That cop in Mount Tawee, he come over my house one day. He said, you're on camera. I got the body. I didn't know what the hell he's talking about until later they're talking about it now.
Yeah.
I guess I was the first one with him. Oh, you're on camera. I don't care if I'm on camera or not. I'm like, I behave myself. I respect the policeman. I don't do anything wrong. Seems like I don't do anything wrong, but it seems I always get in trouble. When I get off the phone with my sister, she says, all right, don't get into trouble. That's a good one, right? Don't get into trouble. So, it's all about you, Judge Jordan. It's all about you, what you're doing to me. I wish you could watch Channel 34 and 35. You can see what a ass I'm making out of myself. Maybe you feel guilty or whatever. So, the more I talk, the more I keep doing what I'm doing, I get more trouble. More trouble. Well, like that lady before me, she wants to speak her mind. I don't blame her. I'm the same way. I don't know if I'm accomplishing anything or doing anything right. Where's my guardian angel? No, lady told me there's angels. Where's my angels to protect me or help me? I don't get nothing. Nothing at all. Always the bad stuff. The bad stuff. Like the other day, I'm at Costco's. I got everything prepared. I got an American flag.
Mr. Messer, your time is up. Your 5 minutes is up.
But
Mr. Coughlin will look at the paper that you have after the meeting.
Okay. I apologize, George. Boy, we're out of time. See you next time. See you tomorrow in Port Dan, boy.
Thank you. Are there anybody else coming before us tonight?
President, Vice President, Councilman, Administrators, Woodbridge Township. If history has proven anything to us, it's proven that sometimes people are right and sometimes they're wrong. And then sometimes we, as human beings, make mistakes. And
I'm sorry to interrupt you, but could you just state your name and your
title? Oh, I apologize. I'm sorry. I thought most people knew me. I apologize. Just Phil Hall from Colonia, Willow Street, 5th Ward, who the Honorable Debbie Mim is my councilwoman, and she does a great job, by the way. But sometimes we make mistakes, and I'm here to attempt to correct perhaps a mistake, and I'm going to even go with a misunderstanding. I was listening to the young lady speak, but I would be happy to give you a hug afterwards.
Well, please do, because
I certainly will.
I got a man, he gave me one, he didn't do any good.
It would be my
pleasure. Shut up from him.
But my point is this. I want to speak on behalf of Vito Simaluca, who happens to be one of Woodbridge's finest. He's an administrator that does everything in his power to ensure that the residents and the citizens of Woodbridge Township have the absolute best environment and events and anything to deal with the public that they can possibly get. And I know that because I've been the president of the Independent Club of Colonia, which is a historical black organization since 1999, and the Independent Club has been around since the mid-40s. Now, traditionally, what we do is, obviously, we work within the community and we attempt to make our environment better, the community, and Woodbridge Township as a whole. And I have to say, in all honesty, that Vito Simulope is one of the few people, not, that's a bad word, he's one of the people that I go to for any and everything without hesitation, and generally he gets it done in some shape, form, or fashion. So I'm just going to suggest that if you have a problem with Vito, I think that the intelligent and the civil thing to do is to speak to him, and I'd be willing to bet my life, and I say that without hesitation, I would bet my life that Vito will resolve the issue for you without hesitation, and I assure you that. There are three things that I'm very positive about. Number one, it shows I live, I'm going to die. Number two, there is a Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Yes,
and And number three, Vito is not a racist by any means, shape, form, or fashion. I know him as a friend, I know him as a gentleman, and above all, he happens to be a great man of faith. And that kind of separates him from a lot of people that are out here in today's society. But I just wanted to come and speak on his behalf because he's humble. On February 18th, we have a Black History celebration every year. And I'll let you know about it. Perhaps you can come and maybe get involved.
After you talk to me.
Absolutely. You could probably offer some great insight for us. But my point is, we recognize people within the community that just do an outstanding job year in and year out. Vito Luca's name came up in 2016 for a 2017 award directly after the event was over, and it was unanimous that we were going to celebrate him and his achievements. It was interesting to know that with that, we had to determine out of the awards that we give, which one would we give him, whether it was going to be a diversity award, outstanding achievement award, an excellence award. And by virtue of he being who he is, he could have gotten them all. We could have gave every single one of those awards to him as an individual. But we had to make a selection. We gave an outstanding achievement award because of the time that he puts in, the effort that he puts towards the community of Woodbridge Township. And I'll just share with you two stories, if I might. Number one, when I have an issue, Vito says, Phil, you can call me anytime. I had to call him on a Saturday. One Saturday, it was like 9 o'clock in the morning. He answered the phone. I went through an array of things that I was concerned about. Not problems, concerned. He said to me, no problem, I'll take care of it. I said, okay, and if it wasn't for another week, little did I know he was on vacation. I said, Vito, you shouldn't answer the phone. He said, Phil, I don't mind. My job doesn't end at 5 o'clock on a Friday. And he kind of said that to the wrong person. I called him back several months later. He was on vacation, and he answered the phone again. I said, Vito, you got to be kidding me. But that's the kind of guy he is. But I did learn something. I don't call him on the weekends as much now. I do limit it Monday through Friday from 6 a.m. to 12 midnight. So I try to cut it back. But my point is, he answers the phone. He's always there for anybody that calls him. So I think that if we just settle down, take a moment to speak to the man that he is, I think all your problems will be resolved. And I do empathize with you in terms...
Because you don't know...
I'm not done. I do empathize with you in terms of what you've been going through, and it shouldn't happen to you or anybody else. Councilmen, women, I thank you very much. Vito Simulope, I love you.
Are there any comments from the public? Can I get a motion that the public portion is
meeting
to be closed?
Well, can I
call you? Sorry. All in favor, aye. Opposed.
We'll now move into the agenda part of the evening. My agenda is in order. I just want to thank everybody that came out on Sunday to the J.J. Biddings Chili Cook-Off. It was a great success. We helped two children from Woodbridge Township, one little girl that's three from Colonia, and another little boy from Avenel that's five. So thank you for everybody that came out. Big shout out to Mike Cerami, who always puts this on every year, and Rose from the Recreation Department did a fabulous job. So it's wonderful. Councilwoman Drum.
Thank you, Council President. I'll did on that. Wonderful time. It was actually their 10th anniversary of hosting the Chili Cook-Off, and you got to hand it to them and most of our local businesses that really, you know, they support us. We have to patronize them, and they're always doing some really cool stuff. So thank you for your efforts as well, and Rosemary and Eileen and Brian, so thank you. Relay for Life is June 10th at Woodbridge High School this year. The kickoff celebration is on March 23rd at Miller's Ale House at 6:30. If anybody has any questions, you can call Amy McDevitt at 732-887-5640. The Downtown Merchants Association, I guess I'll just announce the St. Patrick's Day Parade that's coming up this Sunday. The flags look beautiful. Mr. Henry, your staff did a great job this year. They're hanging very nicely. It looks beautiful. So we're all excited for the parade. It kicks off at Woodbridge High School at 1:30, I believe, this Sunday. So I hope you can all make it. The animal shelter, the Woodbridge Animal Group, is having a giant yard sale on April 1st. If you're interested in participating to support the animal shelter, you can email woodbridgeanimalgroup@yahoo.com. We have a bi-local meeting coming up on March 22nd at 5 p.m. in the mayor's conference room. If you are interested, you can call myself at 732-750-9355 or contact Councilwoman Meehan. We had the bi-local committee out of the Green Team Advisory Group, and we're looking for some new people to come on board with us. You can't hear me? PACE, save the date, April 30th at Matthew Jago School for their annual walk and carnival fundraiser. And 18, the Chamber of Commerce, we're having our first nonprofit summit, which is on March 22nd at the Woodbridge Elks from 9 to 12. The panel of key esteemed professionals will include Wiss & Company, Willens, Goldman & Spitzer, Toshiba, Northfield Bank, East Coast Title Agency, Venezia Nolan, and JLR Consulting. And our keynote speaker will be David Justice. We call him Lemonade Dave because he entered into the Guinness Book of World Records for providing the most lemonade. And his story is very, very profound. And it has to do with his daughter. And there'll be a lot of testimonials and a lot of knowledge that can be gained at this very first time the Chamber's putting it on at the Woodbridge Elks from 9 to 12. Breakfast will be served. It's free for our Chamber of Commerce members. And for our non-members, it's $25. Contact the Chamber at 732-636-4040 for additional information. And the Chamber wanted me to announce the Director of Homeland Security will be Chris Rodriguez, will be presenting on April 25th at the Willens Law Firm, and we will be providing lunch, and that is also free to our Chamber members, and there's a nominal fee for our non-members, so we're looking forward to having people come out for that. And number 19, Sustainable Jersey Solar Channel Challenge. Woodbridge Township is working with Sustainable Jersey, who partners with Energy Sage to encourage the adoption of solar energy. You can contact Tom at 732-602-6056 or email wbsolar@twp.woodbridge.nj.us. And on behalf of the Woodbridge High School, their senior play, The Addams Family, will be on the 23rd, the 24th, and the 25th of March at 7 o'clock at Woodbridge High School. And on Sunday, the 26th at 2, and they always do a production for the senior citizens, which is free. They perform that, and that'll be on Tuesday, March 21st at 4 o'clock. And I have one more announcement for electric vehicle charging station grant for businesses. New Jersey's Electric Vehicle Workplace Charging Grant Program provides grants to employers to offset the cost of purchasing and installing electric vehicle charging stations. Upon completion of work in accordance with the eligibility criteria, the NJDEP will reimburse each applicant as follows: up to $250 per level one charging station and up to $5,000 per level two charging station. Applicants will be considered on a first-come, first-served basis. And for more information, you may visit their website at drivegreen.nj.gov. Thank you. That's all I have.
Thank you, Councilwoman. Councilman Anderson.
Thank you, Councilman. My agenda is in order. I just want to announce the Rush Street PTO Tricky Tray fundraiser, which is on April 7th. Although the tables are sold out, there are still needs for sponsorships of prizes to be raffled off. If you have any opportunity to donate for this cause, please email Natalie Nogueras at Gmail. So it's Natalie, Natalie dot Nogueras at Gmail. Or you can call 732-789-3203. Appreciate your efforts. It's for a very good cause at a very good school. Mrs. Giordano, the principal, is doing a fine job there, and just want to commend them on selling out the event so soon. That is all I have.
Thank you. Councilman Figueroa.
Thank you, Council President. Just a few quick announcements under item one at the Woodbridge Community Center. The community center is running smooth, even though the weather varies from very hot to cold. You can stop by there and request a tour. You can call our member services at 732-596-4170 or njwcc.com, New Jersey Woodbridge Community Center. We have a number of activities, just to list in case you don't know. Swimming pool, indoor track, workout rooms for strength and cardio, and all kinds of group lessons. A lot of good things going on there. NJWCC.com or stop by for a personal visit. April is Youth Month and May is Senior Month, and activities will be coming out shortly on that. Mr. Simaluka, I know I ask you this every meeting, but our 4th of July celebration is July
3rd.
July 3rd, which is a Sunday. All right, so Sunday, July 3rd, which means the park will not open until 4 o'clock. So we're going to get that announcement. I know that's a ways off. And also our annual pizza run, which is also in Alvin P. Williams Park, will be on July the 6th. So those are some recreation, health activities going on in town. And that's all I have, Council President. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Councilwoman Deuces.
Thank you, Council President. I just have one item. Item number six, police community relations. The police department is now accepting senior police academy applications. You can find the applications at the community center, at the senior centers, and online. Again, this is for any senior in our township that is interested on how our police department works. Please visit the community center, the senior centers, or online to get your application. Thank you. That is all.
Thank you. Councilman Spiller.
Thank you, Council Vice President. Item number two, just Mr. Mitch, if you can add to this agenda item, Eric LeGrand Believe Park. I mentioned, touched base on it last meeting. The construction has started with the installation of the handicapped accessible gym equipment in the park. After that, there are several other ideas and things we're going to be doing, including outdoor concerts and events. So I think that's something I'd like to add to that, touch base on it. Speaking of the Arts Village, construction at the Arts Village, Station Village, continues to move full speed ahead. As noted, plans for the Arts Center include a transit center with arts complex, retail space, residential apartments, and dining. I want to thank the administration. They've been going to numerous cities on the East Coast to get, you know, what's perfect, the perfect fit for us for the Avenel Arts Village, so thank you. Item number four, the Port Reading Saints have merged their football program with the St. Cecilia's Golden Knights. The program will now be called the Golden Saints, with the existing Saints complex located in Port Reading being their home field, and it is the 50th anniversary this year of the Saints organization. That is all I have. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilman Small.
Thank you, Madam Vice President. My objection is
thank you. Councilman Patel.
Yes, thank you, Council President. My agenda is in line, but I have a couple of things to discuss. Last week itself, there were like two synagogues were attacked and vandalized. You know, I mean, one's in Chicago, the other one is Indiana. And also in last 2 weeks, there were like four South Asians were shot. Considering those incidents, you know, I mean, wrote a letter to John about 2 days ago, and I'm going to read the letter. Dear Mr. Meech, as you know, there have been several incidents nationally targeting the Jewish American community, the South Asian American community, and other minority groups. While we have not had these types of issues in Woodbridge, I believe that it would be helpful to temporarily increase the police presence in sensitive areas such as our Jewish cemeteries and neighborhood like Oakley Road. Our police are already doing a great job, but increased visibility would likely help alleviate concerns within these communities as well as serve as a deterrent to potential bad actors. I'm also happy to communicate any messages from the administration regarding public safety to my constituents. And after I wrote that and I got the message, I would like to also thank Mr. Meech, our administration, and especially our, you know, police chief Huberner, that I think we are already working on it. I think we already have more police presence. Mr. I think Huberner, you could address that. But we are already providing, you know, like additional police presence by the, you know, Jewish cemetery. So that's a great thing. I would like to also again thank, you know, everyone, and we'll see how we can do, I think, Oakley Road and other stuff. And I have one announcement. March 22nd, that's Wednesday, there will be a cooking around the world demo for the general public at the main library starting at 6:30 p.m. This cooking demo will be presented by the Royal Albert Palace located in Falls. There will be enough Indian food items prepared and served by the chef from the Royal Albert Palace. The admission is free to this demo. The admission to this demo is free to the public. And this event is organized by Ms. Patty Anderson. She's the assistant director at the Woodbridge Public Library. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Mitch.
Thank you, Madam President. Just a few items. Under number one, B through D are under investigation by the police department. You'll see some responses on them shortly. 3A, just to make a note in your calendars, May the 11th, if you want to attend the annual retail licensee training for liquor licenses. Drop down to 7A, a reminder that this Tuesday is the Special Board of Education referendum election. Polls will be open from 2 to 8 p.m. Registered voters can participate at their normal polling places. And just a reminder, we'll retire into executive session at the close of the meeting. The public will be excused.
Thank you, Mr. Mitch. We'll move to administration. Mr. Landolfi.
Thank you, Council President. Before I go through my agenda, there is one item I'd like to report on, and actually was mentioned earlier in the meeting. At the last council meeting, there was an allegation of racial discrimination by a citizen against one of our employees. And I want to assure council that we do take those types of allegations very seriously. And in this instance, what I would like to report is that we've retained the services of a retired Superior Court judge who will undertake a thorough and independent investigation of the allegation, including contacting, having communication with the complainant in this instance. So again, it isn't something that we treat lightly. We take it very seriously. We understand the implications. We anticipate that investigation will take some time to complete, but we are fully dedicated to the concept that we take a thorough look at it, that it be done independently, and we'll abide by any conclusions that result from that investigation. The second issue along the same lines is the situation that was this I referred to now, two council meetings, where bathers of opposite sex are in the same locker area has been addressed. We have placed a shower on the pool deck floor that will accommodate the needs of bathers and eliminate that situation. In addition to that, and I said this the last meeting, we retained an architect. We're going to convert two of the showers at the community center to ADA accessible family showers. So that going forward, there'll be three facilities at the community center that will accommodate the need for bathers. In effect, if the requirement is, if they need to, parents, guardians, adults, whatever, to take children with them into a shower, they'll be able to do that discreetly. So we're very sensitive that there was an underlying issue there, and again, we've started to address it. There's one facility in place, it's on the pool deck, and two additional facilities that require architectural drawings and renderings and schematics will be erected over time. And before I go any further, and it really is an aside, I would like to thank Mr. Hall for his comments tonight. He's a well-respected member of the community. I think his service and his integrity is well-known and it's well-established, and we heard what you said, and we appreciate your support. On to my agenda, Council Vice President. We're going to request a resolution adopting a personnel handbook. That's something, it's a policy we started a few years ago, and every 2 years we come back to you, ask you to readopt it. We then make you aware of changes as we go forward. I believe you have a copy of that on disk, and if there are any questions or comments, if you would, let me know. But then, if not, we'll ask you to adopt it the next meeting. I'm going to drop down to the ordinance authorizing transfer of property. In effect, that's a minor transfer of property that is needed for redevelopment purposes. We're going to ask you to adopt best practices resolution. Every year we're required statutorily to complete a best practices sheet that has enumerates, I think this year it's about 30 best practices. The resolution would require you to state that you've reviewed the best practices that we've placed before you, that you understand and that you agree. And I will tell you that we are well within the percentage that we need to be qualified for state funding. We'll have a housekeeping resolution amending a prior resolution. We're also going to ask you to support a resolution with regards to our pre-application to the Green Acres Program for a diversion of property. That, in effect, is the Bowtie Pool property that we are going to ask you to divert to Conrail to accommodate their switch project that ultimately will lead to a dramatic decrease in the amount of train traffic behind Rosewood Lane. That is a very lengthy process. One of the first steps is to have you support our pre-application to Green Acres. I'm sure Councilman Small is probably going to move that resolution. Also have, and this along the same lines, an award of contract to Mott McDonald for construction management bidding inspection of the West Avenue Park parking lot. That is in conjunction with that diversion and will actually be a part of the build-out of the park. We'll have three awards of bids, the elevator for Oak Tree Road School, General Hardware, and also lumber, and a refund of a state tax appeal. Not on my agenda. We're going to ask you to approve the contract for CME for the 2018 road program. And I think Mr. Mitch has already done it, but we've requested an executive session with council this evening. That's all I have, Council Vice President. Thank you.
Nothing tonight. Thank you, Council Vice President.
Thank you, Council Vice President. I have three items tonight. The first is a refund for health licenses 297, 296, and 295 that were paid in us in error. The second is a mini grant from the New Jersey Association of County and City Health Officers. That's a $1,500 grant for public health planning. And the third but not least is our Department of Health and Human Services annual report. You probably remember last year the local health report is given to each council member. It is required by public health practice standards, and basically what it does is it describes not all our activities, but the mandated activities for local health departments, generally inspections, health education, and animal control. And basically what I'd like to do is invite all council members and the public to our April 8th Public Health Day, where we'll have a more in-depth presentation of the annual health report. Thank you, Council President.
Thank you for
the
I have one item tonight. It's a waiver on the stage fee, and I'd also like to thank Mr. Hall for his kind words. I truly appreciate it. I appreciate his love and friendship. Goes right back at him. Thank you.
Thank you, Council President, Council Vice President. Tonight, or actually be a resolution in 2 weeks for the five-year forestry plan. Every 5 years, we need to do a full-on forestry plan, and this is the resolution that endorses that. Thank you.
Nothing tonight. Thank you, Council Vice President.
Nothing this evening, Council President. For Section 8 of the Open Public Meetings Act, Chapter 231 of the Public Law 1975 permits to exclude the public from certain circumstances in a meeting, and whereas this public body is of the opinion that those circumstances presently exist, and therefore be resolved by the Municipal Council of the Township of Woodbridge, that we will, Council will retire into closed executive session for approximately 10 minutes to discuss personnel matters. At this time, I would ask the public to please excuse themselves. I get a motion.
Motion.
I got a second.
Second.
Thank you. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Can I get a motion to reconvene the meeting?
Motion.
Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The meeting has reconvened. If there's no...
Can I have a motion to adjourn?
Motion.
Meeting adjourned.